So I'm not saying about iOS or Android, anything. If you want to develop any software applications, generally we have three basic software requirements. The first one is IDE, Integrated Development Environment. The first thing what we need is we need definitely one environment where we are going to develop the total project of the total project. So the second requirement is some libraries. So where we can call it as frameworks also. So we need so many libraries which are existing. So based on the technology what we are going to develop, technology people provide so many existing libraries. Without those libraries, application development is so difficult. That's why definitely we need some libraries. The third requirement is, according to the technology, we need definitely one programming language. The third requirement is a programming language. So these are the three basic requirements. So software requirements, environment, libraries provided by the technology, according to programming language. These are the three basic requirements. But actually here, what is the technology we are going to discuss is iOS, iPhone operating system. So it's a mobile technology, mobile applications. So of course, still we have three requirements. The three requirements as we discuss, IDE, library and programming language. When it comes to particularly iOS technology, what is the IDE we are using? The thing is Xcode. The name of the environment, the name of the integrated development environment what we are using for iOS development is Xcode. The second one is libraries. Actually, whenever we are installing software, automatically we are getting so many libraries provided by Apple regarding iOS technology. So generally we are calling it as Cocoa Touch. Here Cocoa Touch, in the sense, whatever the libraries provided by Apple regarding iOS technology, all the libraries, all the frameworks, totally combinedly we are calling it as simply Cocoa Touch. The third requirement, as we discussed, one programming language. What is the programming language we are using here to develop iOS project is Objective-C. Objective-C. This is the third requirement. Whenever we are having these three requirements, definitely we can develop iOS, basic iOS projects. First of all, we'll see brief introduction into all these three, then we'll show practically. First of all, the first requirement is Xcode. So what we are saying is Xcode is the environment where we are going to develop the total project. Okay, generally what is the use of environment? Can we develop the application without environment? Definitely no. So environment, in the sense, that is the place where we are going to develop the total project. So that is Xcode. What happens is whenever we are installing, generally what is the operating system we are using for our system is macOS. Generally on macOS, that is the full form is Macintosh, we have to install the software called Xcode. Whenever we are installing Xcode on corresponding operating system, we are getting the first two requirements automatically. We are getting the IDE called Xcode, and as well as whatever the libraries they are providing, we are getting automatically. The first two requirements are default whenever we are installing the software called Xcode. The third requirement, Objective-C, as usual, we have to learn, we have to implement while developing the application. So that is first. The second one is Cocoa Touch, as we said, that is also automatically we are getting, and Objective-C. This is generally what are the basic software requirements to develop any software applications. But here, first of all, Xcode. Internally, Xcode has two more sub-environments, that is Interface Builder, and the second one is iOS Simulator. Right? So actually, whenever we are saying what is the IDE is Xcode, that is right. But Xcode has internally two more sub-environments, we can say, that is Interface Builder, iOS Simulator. Generally, whenever we are developing a project, physically we can divide the project into two parts. One is business logic, second one is user interface, graphical user interface. right? But logically, I can divide the project into four parts. The first one is business logic as usual. The second one is GUI, graphical user interface. And the third one is integration between both bots. And the finally fourth one is output, a result. So these are the four logical parts we have divided: business logic, GUI, integration, and finally output of the application. Here Xcode means where we can write the total coding part of the application. The second sub environment is interface builder. So the meaning itself, it has meaning, interface builder. You can build the interface, GUI. You can build the interface. The third one is integration. Actually, interface builder will do two things. One is you can build the interface. Second one is you can get the integration between both parts. Without integration between coding part to interface, also business logic to GUI, definitely we need some integrations. How to do integration? Here itself we are using interface builder because of integration also. Finally, we have the third one, that is sub environment called IOI simulator, which is useful to show the output of the application. Like this, in the total environment called Xcode, we can complete the total project, that may be code or UI or integration, that means connections, or finally output of the application. These are the things, these are the basical things, what are the basic software requirements we need, and how to write the code, where we have to write the code, all these things. This is a basic software requirements which we need to develop complete iOS project. So clear? So this is generally things. Practically, if you are coming, see, this is generally Mac operating system. On Mac operating system, as we discussed already, whenever we are installing the software called Xcode, we are getting this icon. This is Xcode. Whenever we are installing the software called Xcode only, we are getting this particular icon, right? So if you want to install Xcode, first of all, the operating should be Mac only. So click on Xcode. If you want to open a new project, if you want to do any iOS project, you have to click on Xcode. Go to Xcode, File, New Project, like this. Like this, you have to open new project. Click on Xcode, go to File, New, like this project. See, this is, we are calling it as different templates. Here we have iOS, macOS. Generally, when it comes to Apple, there is iOS development and there is Mac development also. But we are iOS developers. If you want to develop iOS applications, always we have to select iOS. If it is Mac development, they will select macOS. So we have to select iOS. Then these are called templates. We have different templates like master detail, empty application, single view application. These are called different templates. If you are selecting any template, finally we can develop iOS applications only. But each and every template has its own intention. Depending on the situation, depending on the requirements, we are going to select particular templates. But what is the difference between each and every template? What is the case we are selecting particular template? All these things we are going to see later. First of all, for example, empty application, if you are selecting this template, right? So generally empty application means that is empty template. We are getting simply empty. So from this scratch, we have to create. Right. So for example, if you are selecting empty application, right? So click on next. Here we have product name. Generally product name in the sense project name. Whatever the project name we are going to develop, you can use that particular project name. For example, I'm writing some project name demo, some X, you can write anything. Next, generally we are getting all these things like empty. The organization name, company identifier, all these things we are getting empty. Here if you are observing, we have one option called bundle identifier. Here we have a procedure that is syntax that is called com.yourcompanyname.demo. So how we are getting all these things means, so product, if the product name is empty, we are getting like this com dot company name dot product name. Whatever the product name we are providing, like this we are getting. And company name, whatever the company name. So what is the structure we have to follow? Com dot some company name. You can provide any name, some company name. Like this, whenever you are providing company identifier, you have to provide like this only, something com dot some x, and product name also something. So automatically we are getting bundle identifier. That means bundle identifier is always we are getting depending on company identifier and product name, and then organization name. Actually organization name is nothing serious. Actually what happens is, whenever we are developing a project, generally we are getting developed by some name. So whatever the name we are betting, we are providing here. So in future, developed by some XXX, like this we are getting. So organization name means generally we are providing developer name or company name. That is your wish. And then we are having some one more option called devices. So actually, if you want to develop application specifically for iPhone, you have to select iPhone. No, sir, if it is iPad means, you can go for iPad. No, I want to develop applications for both iPhone. It is useful for iPhone, iPad, iPad Touch, like this means you have to select universal. That means depending on our requirement, you can select the particular device. And class prefix. Actually, whenever we are selecting particular template, definitely we are getting some auto-generated classes, which we are going to see later. Definitely every template we are selecting, we are getting some auto-generated classes, that may be one or two. Whatever the auto-generated classes we are getting, the class name is default we are getting. Before the class name, if you want to provide any prefix, you can provide. For example, if I am providing something like my. So they are providing so many auto-generated classes, at least one auto-generated classes. Before the class name, we are providing my. If you are not providing anything also, no problem. So this is strictly optional. Class prefix means, whatever the auto-generated classes we are getting, before the auto-generated classes, if you want to provide any prefix, if you want, you can provide, otherwise you can leave it. That's not an issue. But whatever the classes we are creating in future, user-defined classes, so that is not related to class prefix. User-defined classes, you can provide any name. This is strictly regarding auto-generated classes. So that's why that is not mandatory, that is optional. So finally, core data. Actually, this is not mandatory. Core data is nothing but database. If you are using database to this particular project, you can select, otherwise you can leave it. So click on next. So here I want to save somewhere else. So select some folder. So I want to save on desktop, or you can create your own folder, something like I'm creating one folder called batch one something. So create. So on desktop, I'm creating a folder called batch one. Under this folder, automatically new project will create. Here, what happens is we have selected one template and we have provided whatever they are asking, product name, organization name, company name, device, like this, whatever the options they have provided, we have provided all these things. That's it. So automatically we are getting the environment. This is the environment we are calling it as Xcode. So what we have discussed already, Xcode is the IDE, Xcode is the environment where we are going to develop total project. So this is that environment, Xcode, where we are going to develop total iOS project of the application. Here, first of all, here we have a run button. So if you are placing cursor on this one, we have build and then run the current screen. After completing the project, if you are clicking on this one, it will show you output of the application. You can observe here, first of all, it is compiling. Why? Because here build and then run. So first of all, build in the sense compilation. Whenever you are clicking on this button, run button, first of all it will do compilation, then only it will go for execution, running the application. Then we can see the result in iOS simulator. See, right now it is compiling. It will take some few seconds. Build succeed. Whenever build is succeed, you can see simulator will open. It is running right now. It will take some few seconds. Like this. Actually, we didn't write any code. We didn't develop anything. So we can get the empty screen. Just a second. Still it is running. very first time it will take some time. Just a second. A white color screen, white color window. Why? Because it is an empty application, we are getting output like this. But whenever we are designing, whenever we are writing some code, so we can see the result here. This is output. So where we can see the result? This is called IOS simulator, which is fake to the real device. This is simulator, which is very, very similar to the real iPhone. So which is fake one. So like this you can see the output of the application. See it. Actually, here we need to explain the total environment. Actually, what happens is just we discuss what is the environment, what we have to do. But here in this environment, we have so many parts. You can observe we have so many parts here. Right? So like we have so many folders, so many environments are there. So each and everything we need to explain. Why? Because on the Xcode, we have to develop the total project. That may be code, business logic, that may be GUI, that may be integrations, that may be output, all these things. So where we need to write the code, when we need to design the screen, how to design the screen, right? So how to get the connections, right? All these things we need to learn, right? So all these things we are going to learn later in regular classes. This is generally how we are going to develop the application, what is the environment, what are the basic requirements we need to develop complete iOS projects, all these things. But if you want to explain all these things, it will take much time. So we'll see the each and every point where we need to develop application, how to write the code. We need to explain each and every segment of editor. So it will take much time. But still, this is an overview regarding how to create a new iOS project, new Xcode project, like this. Introduction into iOS, why? Because both are different. And introduction to Objective-C. Before Objective-C, introduction into C, CPP, that's not it. Actually, CPP is not required, but actually Objective-C is inherited from C. That's why introduction into Objective-C. And we are going to learn the complete Objective-C programming language from very basics, like what is class, what is method, each and every syntax structure, the complete Objective-C programming language we are going to discuss. Those are those topics, method creation syntaxes, object creation syntax, data types, class structure, naming conventions, like all the topics we need to cover. Why? Because before going to start the iOS technology, first of all, we need to learn Objective-C programming language very clearly. Why? Because regarding the coding part, programming language very, very important. Without having knowledge on Objective-C, we can't write the coding part of the application. That's why very clearly from very basics up to the high level, the entire Objective-C programming language, we are going to learn all the topics. After that, we are going to start memory management. How to do manual memory management. Actually, right now, to be frank, we have a topic called ARC, automatic memory management only. But before we are going to discuss manual memory management, that is memory management, MRC, manual reference counting. So all these topics we are going to cover. What are the topics like alloc, new, retain, all these are under memory management only. After that, we are going to cover the topics like properties, categories, what are the object-oriented programming concepts we are using in Objective-C or iOS. Like all these topics we are going to cover, like when it comes to extended classes, subclassing, categories, protocol, static binding, typing. So all the topics up to modern Objective-C. Why? Because what is modern Objective-C in this sense? In these days, we have so many changes from in Objective-C. The change, technically we are calling it as modern Objective-C. That means from very basics to up to modern Objective-C, each and every topic we are going to discuss initially. Why? Because without having knowledge on these things, iOS development not at all possible. This is the core concepts. After completing these things, we are going to use, we are going to learn one library. Actually, already we have discussed, iOS provides so many existing libraries. One of the existing libraries is Foundation. Why we are learning this Foundation library individually means Foundation library is useful while writing the code of the application. Without having knowledge on Foundation library, though you have knowledge in Objective-C, still we need some knowledge in Foundation also. Why? Because Foundation library has so many classes like string, array, dictionary, like so many things. These are the classes we are using to manage the data part of the application. So that's why initially, before going to start, after Objective-C, we are learning Foundation library. What are the classes they are providing? What are the methods they are providing? How we are managing coding part by using all these classes and methods? All right? What is the importance of all these classes we are learning initially? Then only we can start iOS. So whenever we are having complete knowledge in Objective-C, whenever we are having knowledge in the library called Foundation, then only we can start iOS. So then, after completing these two parts, actually I am dividing iOS into three parts. Actually, iOS is only one technology; there is no parts. But while learning the total technology, we are dividing, for our convenience, we are dividing into three parts. One is a programming language, Objective-C. One is one of the library provided by Apple, that is Foundation. After getting some knowledge, complete knowledge in those two parts, we are starting complete iOS application development program. So initially, introduction into iOS app. So in iOS application, we are getting so many technical words like UI window, UI view, what is view controller, what is the iOS app lifecycle, what is views and controllers, what is the pattern we are using. So these are all under introduction into complete iOS applications. This is we are going to discuss. After discussing all these things, we are going to explain regarding during controls. Actually, iOS people, they are providing so many controls like label, button, text field. So we need to learn each and every control. What is the use of control? In which cases we are using particular controls? That means we are learning practically the usage of each and every control provided by Apple. Why? Because these are the controls we are using while developing iOS applications. All the controls, whatever the controls they are providing in the library, each and every control purpose we are going to learn practically. Then protocols. Actually, very important topic from iOS technology is protocol. Actually, without protocols, application development, why they are providing this particular topic, protocols, we are calling it as callback methods, delegation, all these are same. Delegation is the pattern they are providing to simplify the iOS development process. Very, very important. So we are going to discuss about all these things. What are the predefined delegations they are provided? What is the use of all these things? In which cases we are using? So regarding all the predefined delegations, predefined protocols, we are going to discuss each and everything, and how to, even some cases, if you want, you can create user-defined protocols also. That is also we are going to learn how to create user-defined protocols, all these things. After that, we are going to cover advanced concepts like audio, video, sounds, guesses, singleton object, navigation, step bar, storyboard, Facebook integration, Twitter integrations, parsings, like data persistence means database concepts like core data, user defaults, plist, SQLite, all these things. Finally, how to test in real device, how to submit app into app store. So like we are going to cover all the updates. For example, right now we are learning iOS 7, iOS 8. So in future you can get some other new versions. So all the updations, whatever we are getting, we are going to cover. So these are the things we are going to cover practically from very basics. From the core level, from the very basics, from Objective-C, the total things what we need to develop complete iOS projects, each and everything we are going to discuss here. This is actually.